Hey guys, it's Kaylee. This lesson is on another method of subtracting mixed numbers by converting to improper fractions. Let's get started. Remember that a mixed number is a whole number and a fraction combined. And sometimes it's easier to work with mixed numbers if we rewrite them as improper fractions. Remember that an improper fraction is a fraction that is top-heavy, or has a bigger number in the numerator than in the denominator. To convert mixed numbers to improper fractions, there are a few steps. The first step is we take our whole number 2 and we multiply it by our denominator here, which is 4, so that gives us 8. And then we take that 8 and we add it to the numerator, which is 3. And then we take our denominator of the fraction, and it stays the same, so it's 4. Then we can add our numerator, 8 plus 3 is 11 over 4. So here's our improper fraction that's top heavy, bigger numerator than the denominator, and it's equal to 2 and 3 fourths, our mixed number. All right, now let's use this idea of converting mixed numbers to improper fractions to subtract. All right, so here I have a whole number minus a mixed number. So I have 5 minus 3.5. Let's convert this mixed number here to an improper fraction. So I multiply my whole number by my denominator. That gives me 6. I add my numerator, which was 1. I keep my same denominator. That's 2. So adding across the top gives me 7 over 2. But now I have this 5 here, my whole number. So as a fraction, that looks like 5 over 1. If I need to get a 2 on the bottom, I need it to have the same denominator. I'm going to multiply it by a 1, which is going to be 2 over 2. So now if I multiply across the top, I get 10. Across the bottom, I get 2. So now I can subtract 10 over 2 minus 7 over 2. And this is going to give me 7. 10 minus 7 will give me 3, and I have 2 on the bottom. But I have a top-heavy fraction here, improper fraction, so I need to divide to convert it back to a mixed number. So 2 goes into 3 one time. 1 times 2 is 2. When I subtract these, I get a 1. I'm going to write my remainder as a fraction, so it's 1.5. So the improper fraction 3/2 is equal to 1.5, which is right there. Good, let's try one more together. So here I have 2 mixed numbers. Remember, if I write these vertically, I'd have 2 over 2 fourths minus 1 over 3 fourths. And I would have noticed that I can't subtract these fractions here without borrowing because my 2 fourths is smaller than my 3 fourths. But instead of borrowing, I can convert both of these to improper fractions. So I'm first going to do the top one. 2 times 4 is 8 plus my numerator, which is 2. All over the same denominator. That gives me 10 over 4. And this one, I'm going to do the same thing. 1 times 4 is 4 plus my numerator, 3, all over my same denominator. 4 is going to give me 7 over 4. So now I have 10 over 4 minus 7 over 4. I have the same denominator. So I can just subtract my numerators. 10 minus 7 will give me 3 over 4. And there we have it. Nice work. So now you can choose when you're subtracting mixed numbers if you want to subtract the fractions and maybe borrow from your whole numbers and then subtract your whole numbers, or you can convert them both to impartial fractions and subtract from there. All right, great work. Practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to be clever. Hey, hey.